Good morning, everyone. Let us pray. Father, we thank you very much for your love and faithfulness over our lives. Thank you because to us you are Father, to us you are friend, to us you are rock, to us you are king, to us you are everything. And Lord, we appreciate you for the privilege we have to be called your sons. And Father, by the way of the blood of Jesus, we come today and we receive your help for the journey of this week. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let me say this before we go into the program. It's going to be an exceptional week. It's going to be a week with a difference for you and for all that you represent in the name of Jesus. Why do I say that? All things are working together for your good because you love God and you are the called according to his purpose. Take hold of that. Now we're starting this broadcast on a note of thanksgiving. Psalm 103 from verse 1 to 5. Let's read. Psalm 103 from verse 1 to 5. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with love and kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Amazing, amazing. But this captures the goodness of the Lord unto us. Can we just begin to give him thanks for bringing us this far on account of his love and grace? Father, thank you for your love, for your mercies, for your goodness, for your love and kindness over our lives. Thank you for all the weeks we have seen on earth up till now. Thank you for the outgone week, and thank you for this new week. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Can we appreciate him for healings, for preservations, for provisions, for guidance, for restorations that we have enjoyed up till now? Lord, we thank you for diverse healings, diverse deliverances, diverse interventions, your provisions, your guidance, your leading that we have enjoyed, Lord God, up until now. The glory and the honor is yours in Jesus' name. Can we give him thanks for the victory of the cross? Because that is where our victory began. Lord, I want to thank you for the victory of the cross. Thank you because for my sake, you went to the cross, Lord Jesus, and for me, you earned that victory. You defeated the devil for my sake. And today I walk in victory. I live by victory. Blessed be your name in Jesus' name. Can we thank God for the blood of Jesus, which is the seal over our lives? Today, we are blood bought. We are blood washed. We are blood sealed. We are blood perfected. Lord, I want to thank you for the victory of the cross. And I want to thank you for the blood of Jesus. Today, I'm blood sealed. I'm blood washed. I'm blood bought. I'm blood perfected. The blood of Christ is my identity today. I give you praise and glory in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I want us to read from Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 21. Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 21. And thine ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. When you turn to the right hand and when you turn to the left hand. Can we trust God for sensitivity to the Spirit of the Lord this week? Lord, I receive grace to be extra sensitive to your spirit this week in the name of Jesus. Receive grace to be acute in the spirit, that you'll be acute in the spirit. You'll be so sharp to the promptings and the nudgings of the Holy Spirit this week. I receive grace to be extra sensitive to the nudgings and the promptings of the Holy Spirit this week. Holy Spirit, that your agenda and your counsel will be so clear unto me in the name of Jesus. No ambiguities whatsoever. I will not fail to hear a voice behind me saying, this is the way, walking it, when I turn to the right or to the left. So I have divine inspiration unto divine guidance and divine direction in the name of Jesus. Trust the Lord for hearing ears. Trust the Lord for seeing eyes. Believe the Lord for a comprehending heart for the journey of this week. I receive grace for eyes that see, for ears that hear, and for a heart that comprehends in the name of Jesus, that I will hear you clearly this week, Holy Spirit. I will see you clearly this week, Holy Spirit. I will understand you clearly this week, Holy Spirit. I will see your acts. Interpret your moves this week, Holy Spirit. No errors, no errors, no errors. Can you banish errors from you, from the journey of your life this week? No errors, no mistakes in the name of Jesus. I reject errors. There shall be no errors, Lord, in my life or in my undertakings or in my affairs. No errors, Holy Spirit. You are the spirit of perfection. No errors in the name of Jesus. No errors whatsoever in the name of Jesus. Believe the Lord against setbacks as well. Nothing will set you back this week. Lord, no setbacks this week in the name of Jesus. No setbacks this week in the name of Jesus. And trust the Lord that from every setback that you've suffered, you recover this week. Lord, for every setback, let there be recoveries. For every setback of the past, we receive divine recoveries in the name of Jesus. So we stage our comebacks over every setback. For every man and woman watching this, for every setback of the past, we receive multiple comebacks in the name of Jesus. It's your season of restoration. Can you claim divine restoration? Divine restoration for the years that the locusts, the palmer worm, the canker worm, the caterpillar have eaten. Can you claim divine restoration? I claim divine restoration this week for the years that the locust, the caterpillar, the palmer worm, the canker worm have eaten. I claim divine restoration. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. So trust the Lord for total yieldedness to the Holy Spirit this week. Total yieldedness. Holy Spirit, I receive grace to be totally yielded unto your counsel, unto your will this week in the name of Jesus. It will not be my will, it will be your will. It will not be my agenda, it will be your agenda, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Thank you. Effectiveness. Effectiveness. Psalm 144 and verse 1. What does say, blessed be the Lord my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. If you read that in another translation, it says, blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. What does effectiveness mean? Having the desired result. Can you receive the training of the Holy Spirit, the equipping of the Spirit of the Lord unto effectiveness this week, that you will achieve desired results this week, whether in your job, whether in your career, in your ministry, in your office, in your vocation, in your academic pursuits, you will achieve results this week, your desired results. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I receive the training of the Holy Spirit, the equipping of the Holy Spirit. You are the one who trains my hands for battle and my fingers for warfare, the psalmist said, meaning you know everything and you can do all things. So I release myself to your influence, Holy Spirit, to your training, Holy Spirit, to your empowerment, Holy Spirit, unto effectiveness in the name of Jesus. So I receive effectiveness in the work of ministry. Trust you for effectiveness in my daily life this week. Effectiveness in my going out, in my coming in, as I relate with men, as I relate with women, as I take decisions. Effectiveness in the name of Jesus. Effectiveness round about me. Nothing is defective. Everything is effective to the glory and honor of your name. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, divine favor. It's a promise of God for God's children. Psalm 5 verse 12. For thou, Lord, will bless the righteous. With your favor, you compass him about like a shield. Can you claim this promise? Promises are meant to be claimed for children of God. Can you claim this promise? Lord, I claim the promise of divine favor for me and all that has to do with me. For everyone praying, we claim divine favor this week. Favor, favor. So we receive without asking. Things fall in place of their own accord unto us because of the favor of God. In the name of Jesus, the strangers will favor us. People will know will favor us. Those we do not know will favor us. Wherever we turn to, favor garnishes our lives. Favor this week in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It shall be a week of open doors. A week of open doors. Can you receive open doors? Can you receive open doors this week? We receive open heavens this week as well. It's in the name of Jesus. The Apostle Paul prayed. He said, there is now an effectual door that the Lord has opened up unto me. Let there be open doors unto ministry, open doors unto favor, open doors unto effectiveness, open doors unto reconciliation, open doors unto restorations, open doors of your power. Open doors unto the supernatural and the miraculous for our men, for our women, for those in business, for those in careers, for those in ministry, for those who are students. Let there be open doors to the glory and honor of your name in the name of Jesus Christ. The will of God is paramount. Trust the Lord, you will never go outside the will of God. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, behold, I have come to do thy will, O God, that you will abound in the will of God this week. Lord, I receive grace to abound in your will this week in the name of Jesus. No disappointment from any quarter. All things work together for your good this week. All things work together for your good this week because you love God and you are called according to his purpose. In the name of Jesus, things you never knew anything about, they shall invite you and you will be honored. The blessing is upon you. None can reverse it. See you next week. Bye-bye.